Lorenzo Ceja wants a shout out for his birthday. Lorenzo Ceja.
Lorenzo, happy birthday, Lorenzo Ceja.
Don Flaviano, how fast is too fast for Mikey to go up to 140 or 147?
It's still Mikey's still champion at 130, so we can't think about that right now. We got to see this fight, how strong he feels, and if he feels very strong, then maybe 135 is our next move.
But even
at 135, it's still, you know, we might stay there for a while, 135. And if he looks strong and looks very, very powerful at 135, then maybe they'll move to 140. But we can't make those decisions right now until he fights 135.
Javier Rosales wants to know how much it is to get in the gym.
Gotta talk to Beba. Beba, she's the one in charge.
Okay. Leo Corona, how can he get some Team Garcia gear?
We don't have anything yet. Since all that new logo stuff, we're still working on that. It should be soon, but we don't have anything right now.
Gerardo Zavala wants to know if it bothers you that your fighters don't really get the credit they deserve. It seems like they're always underdogs.
It's always been like that, and I think it's always going to be like that. I don't think I get the credit I deserve either. I think a lot of boxing writers are thinking, you know, with one or two wins, somebody else with one or two wins, that they're better than me. You know, I just got a call from a reporter earlier today, and told me, you know, 2012 was a great year for you. I voted for you for Colonel of the Year 2012, and he said this year you had some down, you know, with Brandon losing two fights and Onito losing one. I said, but did you forget? Right away, I told him. Well, I think this year it has been better than 2012 for me, because Mikey wasn't champ in 2012. Mikey became champion, two division champion this year. Evgeny Gradovich became champion and defended his title two times, and he became champion as the underdog. Jesus Cuellar became champion as the underdog, and then to finish off, Marcos Maidana beat Broner as a big time underdog. So this was bigger than 2012 for me. But if you're just thinking because Brandon lost twice, then okay, then that's your decision, and that's what everybody's gonna try to push for. Oh, Brandon lost twice. Yeah, but look who he lost to. Look at who he lost to. He lost to Manny Pacquiao, one of the best fighters in history.
That was his first fight at 47. It's not like he had time to adjust to the weight class.
So you know, if they're counting, oh, because Brandon lost twice, well then, you know, then, you know, they're not counting all the wins that we had with Mikey, with Evgeny, with Cuellar, and with Maidana. And Nonito won his last fight too. He lost one and won one. So who did better? You know, if they're choosing, who can they choose? Honestly, who can they choose? Give me a name. Who can they choose?
Maybe Mayweather Senior.
Two wins? Two great wins, yeah.
Maybe Roach.
But he wasn't the underdog. Okay, Roach.
I don't think so, because he didn't apologize to me yet, but...
Okay, but Roach, because of Pravnikov, he lost one fight also.
But he wasn't there for the win.
Okay, but that's what I was going to say. He lost one fight this year, and then won the second fight. But Freddie Roach wasn't even there, okay? So he got credit for it, right? Okay, then. That's fine. Cotto, look at who he beat. Honestly,
that was a joke.
Look at who he beat. And Pacquiao beat Brandon. Okay, yeah. He was 4-1 on favorite. So he was supposed to win. So is that more deserving of Mikey winning two division champion, the Russian being the underdog and beating Billy Dib and defending it twice? Cuellar, who was the underdog and winning the fight. Maidana, who was 5-1 underdog and winning the fight. And Onito, coming from a loss to win by knockout against Victor Shinin, who's more deserving? You know what I mean? And it's not because I'm hating. I'm just talking the truth. Who deserves it more? Who is it more? Oh, because Brandon lost twice? That's what everybody's going to be saying. Oh, because Brandon lost twice? You know what I mean? That's not fair. Honestly, if somebody else gets it, you know, I ain't hating. But if I ever win it again, I'm gonna tell them, go fuck yourselves. I don't need it. Give it to somebody else. If they ever call me, because that's the first thing they do, because I remember 2012, yeah. They call me, Robert, you know, we want to call you to congratulate you. You're trainer of the year. If they don't call me this time, I'm telling you, this year was better. 2013 was better than 2012.
Many more honestly, fights?
2013 was better than 2012 for me. And if they don't call me, and if I ever win it again, when they come and say, you know what, fuck yourself, give it to somebody else because one. I swear to God.